स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी चैप्टर नंबर 9, दैट इज फॉर्मेशन ऑफ अ कंपनी. नाउ हाउ डज अ जॉइंट स्टॉक कंपनी कम्स इनटू एग्जिस्टेंस? दिस इज अ वेरी बिग क्वेश्चन. ओके, मीन्स हाउ दिस जॉइंट स्टॉक कंपनी विल कम इनटू एग्जिस्टेंस. सो फॉर द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ अ जॉइंट स्टॉक कंपनी, many legal formalities and decisions has to be taken. Now what are the stages of formation of the company? The first stage is promotion, second one is incorporation, third one is flotation or capital subscription, and the fourth one is commencement of the business. So there are four different stages: promotion, incorporation, flotation or capital subscription, and commencement of business. If we want to set up a private company, then only promotion and incorporation is mandatory. But if it is a public limited company, then all the four stages are compulsory for a business to come into existence. What do you mean by promotion? Promotion refers to the sum total of all the activities by which a business enterprise is brought into existence, means all those activities which are involved into the formation of a company is called as promotion. It is a term of business, not of law. It consists of the business operation by which a company is established, means whatever processes involved in the formation of the company comes under promotion. Like planning, what are your plans? Because for setting up any organization, you need to plan for that organization first. So it is the process of planning. Second is organizing the finances, because without money, you cannot run your business. So it is very much compulsory for you all to arrange for finance and other resources of business enterprises in a corporate form. So first you will plan, and secondly what you will do, you will arrange and organize the necessary things which are required to start up the business. The process of promotion begins with the conception of an idea from which the business is to be evolved. Means suppose if you are thinking of starting up an online shop, so that is your idea, and from there only promotion starts. Whenever you are thinking about something or you are getting an idea to start up something, that from that very stage your promotion begins. Business is to be evolved and ends. When does it ends? When you actually establish your business concern. From the conception of idea to the establishment of your business concern is your stage of promotion. Now, people who perform the task of promotion are known as promoters, okay, or entrepreneurs. So a promoter is a person who gets an idea of the business enterprise. He analyzes it, whether it will be beneficial for him or not, whether he will incur losses or this is not an, you can say, proper idea. So that is your analysis. Next, he starts arranging for materials, machineries, people, other managerial abilities, and also floats the enterprise. So these are very crucial steps which a promoter need to follow. Now, a joint stock company may be promoted in any of the following two ways. In either of the following two ways, you can promote your joint stock company. The first one is by converting your existing partnership or sole proprietorship firm into your joint stock company. Means you are already having your joint stock company. Means you are already having your partnership firm, or you are having your sole proprietorship. Now you want to convert it into a joint stock company. Or secondly, what you can do, you can set up a complete new company or a complete new line of business. You can do either of the two. Is it clear? You can simply convert your partnership or sole proprietorship into joint stock company, or you can start up your new company. Now, promoters. Who are promoters? I have already told you all. Promoters or is an entrepreneur or businessman who gives birth to a business concern. Means he basically gets an idea, he basically gets up with the schemes of operation, schemes of promotion, and has the memorandum of article prepared, because for the formation of any joint stock company, memorandum of article, a memorandum of association is mandatory. Execute and register the funds, the first director settles the preliminary contracts and prospects and make arrangement for advertising and circulating the prospects of the capital. So that person is called as a promoter. Now, under Companies Act 2013, a promoter means a person who is a promoter, firstly, who has been named as such in the prospectus or is identified by the company in its annual return. Means company ke prospectus mein jiska naam hai, and the person who is eligible for the annual return of the company, he is called as promoter. Secondly, who has control over the affairs of the company? It can be directly or indirectly. He is controlling the matters of the company. Third, he is a promoter on whose advices, directions, or you can say the board of directors of the company are performing. Is it clear? So that person will be called as a promoter. Now, ultimately, what we can conclude, that a promoter is the one who undertakes to form a company with reference to a given objectives and set it in motion and take the necessary steps to accomplish that process. So he is considered to be a promoter. That's all for today. In our next class, we'll be studying about types of promoters. Okay. Bye-bye. Take care.